If, however, your feelings have changed, I would have to tell you. You have bewitched me, body and soul, and I love, and love, and love you. I never wish to be parted from you from this day on.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you guys are new to my channel, please like, subscribe, and don't forget to share. Now today's pick a card is going to be about who is your soulmate. So we have three piles to choose from. Pile one is a blue lollipop, pile two is a red lollipop, and pile three is a green lollipop. Take a couple of minutes or seconds and you decide, and then we're going to get right into the reading. Hey guys, okay, if you guys chose pile one, here is your reading. So we are going to go through the cards and we're going to see who is going to be your soulmate coming through. Okay, so the first card that we're going to flip over is going to be right over here. We have passion. Allow your heart and soul to sing with joy. So this person that I definitely see that is going to be coming in for your soulmate, the sign could either be an Aries, Sagittarius, or an Leo. They're going to be very impulsive. Like, they're going to take the initiative. They're going to have a lot of action. They're going to be very athletic. They may even have an athletic body type where it's going to be very mesmerizing. This person is going to take the initiative when they do see you. Like, there's not going to be any hesitation or like, should I or not. They are going to take the initiative up front to approach you. They are not going to waste any time, and they're not going to think twice before looking at you. They will initially see you first with instant attraction. And I'm seeing that this person could also be a Scorpio, because they're going to have really intense energy, and you could feel the energy too also as well. It could be very intense as well, but the energy when you guys are both together, it's gonna be like when you guys look at each other in your eyes, it'd be like more so time will stop. And I mean this literally. Like, some people are like, well, that can't happen, but it can, especially if it's a soulmate or some type of, you know, karmic attraction or some type of karmic relationship. Because instantly when you look into that other person's eyes, it's like a knowing or a feeling or an intuition where you just know you're supposed to be with this person. You're not going to doubt it in your mind. When you guys instantly lock eyes with each other, it'll feel like nobody ever really exists in the world, just the two of you. You're like not going to be able to not recognize each other with complete recognition. You guys, it's going to be, the relationship is going to be very passionate and very, you know, the person's not going to be able to keep their hands off you. They're going to be very, 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 very touchy. So they're going to feel like they need to touch you with, you know, wanting to caress you, wanting to touch your body. So this person is going to have a lot of innate abilities to be able to make you feel a sense of comfort and a sense of security when you're with this person. You're not going to have any hesitation of feeling though you're not going to be safe. Now, we're going to get into the second card, which is this one that we're going to flip over. New love. And see, when I look at this card, particularly the one, I'm going to try to see if I can move this over. When I look at this one specifically with the new love right here. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. This person is going to stir things up in, you know, up inside you, at least with unexpected feelings. Like, you've had other relationships in the past, but this one's going to be like no other. It's just going to be very unexpected, because you're going to feel with so much emotion that you're going to say to yourself, like, why am I feeling this way? Why do I have these deep, intense emotions towards this person? Because the person's going to be completely new to you. This is going to be somebody that you're not expecting to look for. So they're going to come out of the unexpected. So this is going to be like a complete, like, if you're looking for a start over, a fresh new start, this person is going to bring that in your life. And they're going to have emotions that are going to be stirred up amongst yourself that you did not expect that you would be having. Like, you know, like when they say head over heels or falling in love, this person is going to make you feel that. And you are truly going to feel like, this is something that I did not expect that I would get myself into. So that's what I see for the new love. And then this is the one right here, how to manifest your soulmate. This is what you can do to manifest your soulmate in faster, okay? Because I feel like for you to truly get your soulmate in your life, there has to be some type of healing. You have to heal, because I feel like it's not right to start a relationship and you have emotional baggage from other relationships, or just in general, I feel like you just have to go through a lot of healing so that you can ultimately have a harmonious, balanced reunion with one another. So we're going to open this little bag that we have. Okay, it's like a winter wonderland. Somebody gave it to me as a gift, but I'm going to use it for the card that we have to reveal. So we're going to move that away. Okay, so we're going to open this up. And what do we have here? So what does it say? It says, what do I believe about money? And do my beliefs match my dreams? Okay, think about that. And then we have some information over here in the back. How does your relationship with money affect your current situation? Do you believe in you are a worthy? Do you believe you are worthy? Do you believe you are capable? Do you trust money? Does money trust you? Money is the energy, ebbs and flows. You are worthy of it. It is your responsibility to heal your relationship with money as part of waking up to a whole of you and your purpose. And today, when it says soul action, take a deep dive in your belief system around money, and are there beliefs you need to upgrade to create the results and waiting most in your life? Write your money story. It is time for sacred shift. What will your next chapter be? And fill in the blank. I'm grateful to money, because I don't know if you yourself have an issue with dealing with financial issues, with feeling as though that you didn't have enough with money, and feeling as though that you weren't worthy enough to have money. But when you meet this soulmate, you won't have to worry about any more burdens of financial difficulty, because they are going to be able to meet your needs. They will create that long-term financial stability for you for life, you know, like they'll always be there solid and with loyalty to the end of being able to provide and give you what you need as far as your financial needs. So this person is going to have money so that you won't have to worry about not needing want or what you need for your needs and essential needs, that need for clothing and food, because this person is going to be able to take that and basically just gracefully take it and take care of all your worries and fears that you feel that you are incapable of being able to take it. You know, take on for yourself. They will be able to take that for you, and the relationship will be very well balanced and met. So, this is my take on pile one for your soulmate. And please comment down below if this resonates with you. And this person that comes in your life will just be somebody that you're just not expected. And the thing that I pay attention to the most for pile one, pay attention to how this person will make you feel. Okay, you guys have a great day and thank you for watching. Please comment down below and thanks for watching. Bye. Hey guys, welcome. Okay, if you guys chose pile two, this is going to be your soulmate reading. Okay, so let's flip the card over for card number. Okay, for pile two. Okay, free yourself. It is time to take back control of your life. Now, this person could be a Pisces. This person could be a Gemini. Or this person can be Aquarius. When you meet your soulmate, you're going to finally be able to take off that mask. Finally take off that mask that you truly have been hiding. Because you know, like when you meet somebody and you meet numerous people and you have the jack of all trades where you're constantly putting on some type of mask and you're like, ugh. Why do I have to be this? And you could truly be yourself. You could be your true authentic self at times. But you know how society has a tendency to put that you have to put a certain image on and not really portray yourself. But when you meet this person, it's going to feel like you can truly be your authentic self at the core. It's going to be like a fresh breath. It's going to be like a fresh air, just like fresh breath of air. Like you're going to be able to just be like, I can truly be myself, man. This person allows me to truly have the freedom to just be non-judgmental and very accepting of who I truly am inside. I can finally be my authentic self. I can finally be quirky. I can finally be weird in a way and they not be judgmental but be very accepting of my character. So when I look at this card, it makes it look like you could have at some point feels like you could have been around certain people or even other in your past life, past relationships where you couldn't really be your true self. But around your soulmate, this person is going to make you feel and believe in certain ways that you never thought you could ever imagine. You will have the mindset where you'll start to think and do in ways where you didn't even think you were capable of being able to do it. And you'll just start to do things. And your soulmate is going to be very accepting of you, very loving, very caring. They are going to love you at the core where they're going to be very unconditional love. You know, like a lot of people get in relationships and sometimes they have these mindset where, you know, I'm in a relationship. It has to be conditional because it's conditional because I'm getting, it's more like a transaction where, you know, I'm in a relationship and they provide money for me. They put a roof over my head. They give me, you know, food and stuff, but it's more like what I can get out of the relationship. But this person is going to be very unconditional and they're going to love you regardless of who you are, what you have. They're going to be all accepting on every level. It's going to be more like a probably so free on maybe a more of a telepathical connection where you guys are just going to understand each other. You're going to understand each other at a core where it's just going to be very synced together. Where you're not going to need to sometimes even speak in words. You just intuitively know what each other is thinking. So this person is going to allow you to truly be your authentic self at all times. So we're going to get to the other card over here, which is the honeymoon. Okay. Honeymoon, enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. So, like I said, that when you guys come into union, your soulmate is going to make it feel like you're going to say these words like, where have you been all my life? I have been searching for you. Like, this is like a dream that I've never would imagine that would come true. And you know how some people are like, I'm looking for that Prince Charming. I'm looking for that knight in shining armor. this person is going to be the person that is going to take your breath away. You guys are going to enjoy being, you guys are really going to enjoy having quality time together. At the, you know, quality time for you two are, is going to be really nice, fun, relaxing, cozying up. You could like to stay in, maybe, you know, just have a nice lit fire by the fire, just be cozy, just like get under the covers, enjoy maybe hot chocolate, maybe a relaxing bath, even maybe, you know, watch movies together. Just having that quality time is just going to be very purifying and relaxing to be around each other. You're just gonna just love spending quality time with each other. It's just going to be really great. This person is going to be very considerate of your feelings, very considerate of your well-being, very considerate of how you are feeling and what they can do to tend towards those needs and make you feel great inside. I look at this and it kind of reminds me as if there's like wings, and I believe there's wings on here. This person is going to be an angel sent from above, and they are going to come into your life and truly make a difference and amend everything that you've always felt deep down inside. Even if you feel like you've had pain or hurt, this person is going to be able to wash away all those fears and pains away. Like, just wash it away like it didn't even exist and make you feel so good inside. This person is going to be there. And I'm telling you, like, if it's bliss, it's bliss inside. And they're going to be able to be with you on every aspect, on emotional, psychological, and spiritual level. So that's what I'm seeing for your soulmate. So how do we manifest your soulmate? So let's get into the bag and see. Okay, so we're going to take this away. I love this bag. It's so cool. Okay, and then we're going to open this up. Okay, I'm going to move this over here. All right, so what do we have right here? So this is what we're going to have to do to manifest your soulmate. What can I do to make a difference? Okay, so we're going to read and start reading up here. What keeps you up at night? What makes you cringe when you think about it, such that every ounce of your screams no more? Where can you create purpose out of pain? Today's soul action, make a difference in someone's life today, or big or small, because it makes a difference. Now, when I look at this card specifically, it speaks of acts of kindness to one another, speaks of acts of kindness towards helping others. So when you meet your soulmate, this person, you'll be doing what you love the most. Like, if you're a person that is very nurturing and you love to help others and you do the littlest acts of kindness by, you know, holding a door for somebody or helping out in the need of somebody needing help, I don't know, like baking or volunteering. Those little acts of kindness will lead you to your soulmate, because with you giving love and giving back towards others effortlessly, unconditionally, it will recede and reciprocate, where your soulmate will come unexpectedly in the act of the moment of caring and helping someone else. So that's when you will be able to manifest your soulmate, and you'll instantly know, because when you're doing what you love with great passion and in the moment at every time that you're doing it, and something that you love doing, like if you love hiking, if you love cooking, if you love swimming, if you love doing something that provides true happiness, your soulmate will come in when you least expect it. And when they do come in, it will be a sense of comfort and it will be a sense of wonderful excitement. So this is how you can manifest your soulmate. So that's what I have for this reading. If you guys have any questions, feel free to comment down below. And please comment down and share your experience. Tell me what you think, what you thought about this reading. And that's it. That's all I have to say. And oh, don't forget to like, subscribe, and don't forget to share. And you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you. Bye. Hello, guys. If you guys chose pile three, here is your soulmate reading. Okay, let's get in. Okay, so the first card that I'm pulling up is going to be deception. Okay, someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship. I feel like when your soulmate comes in, it's going to be like too good to be true. Like, are you kidding me? Who is this person? Like, you're, because I don't know if maybe in your past relationships you were more guarded or more of a type of person where you were hurt and then you have some more healing to go through. When this person comes in, it's going to be like, this is too good to be true. Like, are you kidding me? This can't be my soulmate. Like, they're going to treat you so well. Like, they're going to put you on literally a throne. They're going to put you on a hierarchy. They're going to put you on a pedestal. They're going to treat you very well. And the thing about it is, they're not going to give up on you. They're going to try their damnedest. Like, they're going to really try their hardest. Try not to cuss too, because this is YouTube. But they're going to really try their hardest to be determined and consistent and patient with you, because they feel like you guys are meant to be together. So you could put up a wall, put up a fight, and make it seem as though that, do I really deserve this person? Am I worthy of this person? And if, like I say, if you do the work to manifest your soulmate and you try to do healing, because I feel like as human beings, when you're here on this earth, I'm all for, and this is just my opinion, I'm all for people getting healing with no matter what the situation that you go through, any trauma or anything that you feel like you need to let go and to release or forgive. I'm all for healing. So this person that is your soulmate is going to be very patient with you. They're going to be very loving towards you, and they're going to be very persistent on making it seem as though like they're not going to give up on you. They know that you guys are meant to be in union, so they will do anything they can to help you. And you know, like some people, they get in relationships and they get down to a point where they're like, I was abandoned by this person, and this person hurt me and they left me. This person is not going to give up on you. They're going to have faith in you. They're going to trust you. They're going to know that you're going to be able to get through any hurdle or any setback. So when I look at this card and it says someone's wearing a false self mask in this relationship, you may not be in the beginning trustworthy towards your soulmate because of what you dealt with in your past. But when you come around and your heart is truly open up enough and healed, you will realize that this person really does get me. This person really wants to love me on every aspect, on every level. And for that, I love them. I love them. I love them truly for life. And there'll be, and that's what I'm saying, like, this will be an ultimate soul mate for a lifetime, because they're going to be very dedicated to you and very loyal. They'll have a lot of loyalty towards you. So every relationship can't always be like harmonious, like in great and balanced. When I look at this and I describe on what zodiac sign I could be, it could be, again, it could be a Scorpio, or it could be a Cancer, it could be a Taurus, and maybe it could be an Aries, but possibly. But that's what I see for this card. I know some people like to pan out and make it seem as though that if you're a soulmate, it'd just be harmonious, but not everything can be always harmonious in a way, because I feel like some people, believe it or not, when you do have a relationship, it's always going to be a give or take. And to balance things out, you're going to have to compromise. But this person is not going to give up on you, and they're going to have total faith in this connection, and they will feel like it will provide some sense of stability. They will feel like they're not going to give up on you personally. So that's what I got for that deception. And then when I pull this card, this one itself, I'm going to move this over because we already saw that one. This one, we're going to move over here where it starts to talk about codependency. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. That's why when I look at this card and it says codependency and it says addictions affecting my life, there's just certain things that you're going to have to work through, really work through, to provide, to be able to have this, that when the soulmate does come in, because this person that is going to be your soulmate is going to be a person that is going to want to be able to build you up. They're going to want to be able to see you at your best. They're going to want to be able to build you up at a point where you are going to ultimately see the truth of who you are. They're not going to hurt you anymore. Like, they're not going to hurt you, and I wouldn't mean anymore. I mean in general. And if you have other relationships where you felt like, you know, if I stay, it'll get better. If I stay, they will get better. But it just never panned out. So it's like, this person will be in your life forever. Where they're going to try to make you feel at best who is the best version of yourself. Like, when I look at this, I'm sorry, but it's just very emotional sometimes when you're doing these readings, because you feel like this person is like, they're going to be with you because regardless of the situation, regardless of what you're going through, like, they're going to be there through the hard times, and they're going to try to pull you up and make you feel the best that you can feel at yourself. Like, psychologically and mentally, they're going to try to literally pull you up from the depths of, if they say, hell, and try to make you a good version of yourself, because they truly can see into your soul and they see the best version of yourself. You may not see it, but they truly do, because they see the strong potential, the strong potential that this relationship can go through. And I know some people make it look like it's not supposed to be hard, but sometimes things, this relationship is going to be very therapeutic. I'm telling you, at the core, it's going to be very healing. It's going to be a healing experience. So that's what I got for this card. So we're going to go right into how to manifest your soulmate. Okay. All right. So let's see. We're going to move this card, take this one away, and then we're going to open up. Let's see what we got over here. Put this one over here. So like we say, okay, so am I apologizing for my truth? Okay, so what part of you is apologizing for your truth and why? Okay, so today, be proud of your truth. Catch yourself when you want to apologize or withhold parts of you. You never know whose life you will change when you are brave enough to speak it. Be the lighthouse that shines the courage that lives in all of us. This will give others permission to speak their own truth. There is room for all of us. Courage is contagious. And that's what I said, that when you meet your soulmate, they are not going to abandon you. They're going to be with you, wanting to help you, wanting you to lift you up and encourage you, to allow you to become a better version of yourself. They see the truth of who you are on all levels. That's why they will not leave easily. They're not going to back down. Like, they want, and you think to yourself, like, this shouldn't be a fight, but they're going to be very patient, and they're going to be very consistent, and there's going to be a lot of perseverance through this relationship, because they want to be with you. They know you are meant to be with one another, and they're not going to give up hope, because they can see that there will be success in the end.